I'm going to take a minute and show you how to use one of these star charts, or planispheres as they're known. Now I'm going to use one here on the computer screen since it's easier to record. Of course you should be doing this with your Uncle Al's handmade star chart. If you're going to do it on a computer, I would probably just use Stellarium because it's way more powerful. I would never use a planisphere on a computer. It doesn't really make sense to me. Of course the power of a planisphere is that it's something you can put in your backpack, put it in the trunk of your car, keep with you, and when you find yourself outside, you're wondering what something is, you can use it to find different objects in the sky. So I just want to kind of orient you to how this works and how you can use it to find stars in the sky. So here's a few things. First, here in the center, this sort of oval shape, right, that's actually the whole sky. And if you look around sort of the green line here, that's our horizon. So you see south here on the bottom, you see southeast, going to the left here, east, northeast, north, northwest. And one of the things you'll notice is that the directions are not like straight up and down and straight left, right. Everything's kind of skewed here, right? And the problem, of course, is that we're trying to project the entire sky onto this oval. And clearly we can't do that totally accurately. And so there's this kind of weird projection where east and west are kind of a little bit more towards the north. You'll also notice that east and west are flipped from the way you would see it on a regular map, right, where you're seeing west and then east. And the reason for that is because what we're using this for is looking up at the sky. And as we look up, as opposed to looking down at a map, the east-west get flipped. So the way you would actually use this is you'd kind of hold it above your head, right? And you'd kind of point north towards the north direction. And so this is supposed to represent kind of the dome of the sky. Now, so keeping that in mind, we'd say that the center of the sky, like straight overhead, the zenith, would be the exact middle here of our entire oval. You'll see these lines on this particular one, on this particular planisphere, all kind of point towards the North Star right here, Polaris, right? And everything kind of rotates around that. That's where you would put sort of the pin in your handmade planisphere, and everything rotates then around Polaris. So now, how do we set this so that this actually shows us what the sky looks like right now? Well, you'll notice that you can kind of rotate your planisphere, and there's sort of two scales up around the edges. And your planisphere will look a little different than this. But on the outside edge, of course, are all the dates. And the inside here, you see these triangles. And these represent the time of day. So 0 would be midnight. And, of course, you have like 1 a.m., 2 a.m., 3 a.m., and 11 p.m., 10 p.m., right? Kind of like military time. So let's just say you were going out at 8 o'clock p.m. on, let's just say, March 1st. So to set the sky for that, what you do is you want your time to match your date, or to point to your date. So 8 p.m. would be 20 here on our time, and we would rotate this so that that 20 points on our calendar to March 1st. All right, so I'll line that up. Okay, and you can do the same thing with your handmade one and see how well the sky matches. All right, so this shows me then what my view of the sky would be. And this is particularly helpful if you want to find particular constellations, right? So let's just say you want to find, what's an interesting, let's say Orion, right? So you see right here is the Hunter, right? So we have Orion, and on yours I'm sure it says the word Orion, and so you could find it in the sky. You'd say, well, I have to look south, it'd be a little ways up. So you'd say, well, here's 0 degrees altitude, the center is 90 degrees altitude, so this is maybe at like 45 degrees altitude up from the sky, about halfway up from the sky, right? So you could try to find Orion that way. Now this can also be helpful if you want to figure out, well, you know, what time is a particular constellation going to rise? Say, for example, Gemini. You want to know when is Gemini going to rise on, let's just say, on January 1st. Okay, so that's a particular day. So what we could do is we could go and move Gemini, the twins here, over towards the eastern horizon. Okay, and I want to know when are they going to rise. All right, so there it is rising on the eastern horizon. And I want to know what time that's going to happen on January 1st. So in that case, I could go look here. Here's January. I can look at January 1st, and I can say, well, what time is it? Well, it's between 17 and 18. So that's 5:30 p.m. it looks like. So I probably won't see it, right, because it'll still be probably light out, but that's when it will be above the horizon on January 1st. So you can use this not only to see what's up right now, or what will be up at a certain time, but you can also use it to try to figure out when will something rise, or when will something set. So let's practice with one other one. Let's just say Cygnus the Swan. And let's try to figure out on what date will Cygnus the Swan be setting at midnight. All right, so see if you can use your planisphere to figure that out. So you find Cygnus, the swan, move it over to the western horizon, and try to find what date will it be setting at midnight. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to take the swan right here. I'm going to move him over to the western horizon. Okay, there it's setting. Let's see, on what date will it be setting? It's setting at midnight, and I look here on my calendar and it says about November 30 or December 1st. Okay, so that's a little test. You can try that out. So that's all you need to know to be able to work one of these planispheres and find different objects in the sky. So now you have no excuse for not knowing any constellations because you can go outside with your planisphere and find them yourself.